As an artist, I have many, many sketchbooks, all different types from different companies, different textured papers, different paper weights, different paper colors. And in today's video, I'm doing a sketchbook tour of one of my, well, not necessarily favorite sketchbooks, but it's a pretty decent sketchbook overall. So let's hop into it. So as you guys can see here, I've opened the first pages or the pre-pages, and this is a die-cut sticker that I created myself using the online sticker paper and my Silhouette Cameo. And now on page 0 and page 1, I have, for the first two sketches, I've decided to create some donuts. I guess I was just hungry for some reason. The first donut I created using some colored pencils. The second one I used some Tombow dual brush pens. But now we're here to the Chucky page. I love Chucky so much. Like, you guys don't even understand. Halloween is just one of my favorite times of year. And scary movies and horror movies, just that whole vibe, I just love. And Chucky is one of my favorite villains of all times. He is really, really fun to draw. And if I could collab with the creators, I would. And here we are with more Chucky and like a little spin-off version of him. So I kind of gender-bended his character into a female character, and this is what she would look like. This spread in particular was really, really fun to do, just like the previous one as well. Just really fun to do. I think I'm going to create like a Chucky print or something, like some fan art soon. So be on the lookout for that. And just kind of continuing with the Halloween theme, skulls are some of my favorite things to draw as well. And on the other side, I have like a half skull, half zombie type creature. I wanted to try and test out the little glitch style that was trending for a while. It didn't come out as good as I would hope, but it's okay. And now we have more skulls and zombies. And again, we're continuing with the Halloween type theme. I promise this entire sketchbook is not going to be about skulls and zombies and evil villains, but they are very, very fun to draw, and I really enjoyed this spread as well. And now flipping over to the next spread, birds are some of my favorite things to draw. I mean, I just like to draw a lot of things, and birds, animals in general, are very fun to draw. In some cases can be a little complicated depending on the animal, but birds are definitely some of my favorite animals to draw. You have many different varieties, different shapes and sizes, different feathers, different colors, and just very cool animals to recreate on page. And again, here we have more Halloween things. Zombies, and I actually created a YouTube short about the zombie in black and white. You guys can check it out if you want. And here on my right, I created a zombie, and the caption is worm food, because zombies are technically worm food and they just come back to life, sort of, kind of. Here on this spread, we have honeybees and bumblebees. This page turned out okay to me. Insects are really cool to draw. I kind of put them in a similar category with animals. They can be complex and, you know, just really fun to kind of figure out how to draw all the parts accurately and just make it look like what it's supposed to look like. I'm currently working on another sketchbook, so you guys are going to see even more insect drawings in that one. I'll talk about that in another video. And here on this spread, we have flowers. I know I say a lot of things are my favorite things to draw, but flowers are, they have to be like top 5 of my favorite things to draw. Like in every sketchbook, you will see flowers, especially chrysanthemums and peonies, my favorite types of flowers to draw. Here, again, on this spread, some of my favorite things to draw. I think everything in this sketchbook will fall in the category of my favorite things to draw. Because food, oh my God, another top five thing for me to draw. So flowers, animals, food, people, and cars are probably my top five things to draw. Not in any specific order, but okay. And I don't know if you guys noticed, but when you see like the day 10, day 5, day 2, or whatever underneath the drawing, that was a part of my Halloween series, my Inktober series. And if you guys want to watch that, I participated in Inktober 2022. Last year, you guys can go watch my playlist, or you can just go to my channel and find the videos. So on this spread, I'm creating owls. Owls are supposed to be these wise creatures, these all-knowing creatures. So I figured, why not create something like a print or some type of a sticker and put in the words like discipline, persistence, faith, consistency, mindset, patience. And I'm thinking about turning this into a print, but I'm going to redesign it, you know. So on this spread, we have more birds. And it's a different type of bird from the first one, of course. Birds are so cute to draw, especially the little small ones with all the feathers. And they look, you know, they're just round and fat and plumpy. Just so cute to me. All right, our next spread, cookies. None of these turned out the way I wanted them to. I mean, yeah, they're cute little graphic style type cookie drawings, but I need more practice with colored pencils, and I don't really like these as much. They came out a little flatter than I would have liked, but that's okay. It's a sketchbook, it's made to make mistakes in, so. This next spread, however, I do like. I bought a Rubik's Cube, and I haven't quite figured out how to solve it. I think I solved one side, and that was it. But, and I am too prideful to look online to kind of see if anybody posted anything about techniques you could use to solve them. But, you know, it's okay. In our next spread, we have shoes. I like drawing shoes. I would say drawing shoes is a top 10 for me. And some of my favorite shoes to draw are definitely Converses or some type of Nikes or Jordans. I also want to create some type of print design and some type of sticker set involving me drawing some type of shoe. All right, moving on to the next spread. I really like this spread. This is one of my favorite spreads in the sketchbook. It's just a pile of fineliners, basically. So sometimes I do this thing in my sketchbook where I pick one object and I just fill the entire sketchbook with that one object. And this time around, it just so happened to be one of my art supplies, some fineliners. And for this next spread, it's a little all over the place, a little choppy. It's not one of my favorite spreads. It didn't come out how I wanted it to, but it's okay. It still came out pretty decent. As I told you guys before, I really like drawing birds. Chickens are birds. I really like drawing all the little intricate parts of the hen. And for this spread, I am... again, not too happy with how this came out. I feel like this could have been better. I kind of dropped the ball with this one, but it's a bunch of different types of mushrooms, and I'm using Micron pens and Tombow dual brush pens to kind of complete the look. But yeah, again, this spread is a little underwhelming for me. But we're going to move on anyway to the next spread. So on the left, I created a portrait of a fictional character I just kind of came up with at the top of my dome. And I was using colored pencils. And on the right, she is actually a part of my Inktober series, as you can see. What day did that say? Day 19. So yeah, it was just me practicing with colored pencils and fineliners. Another disappointing spread for me. So even though this did not turn out as I wanted it to, like the concept of this cat person in a dress, I like that concept. So I'm going to play with that even more in the future, maybe create some prints and some stickers out of it, you know, some cats with these long, beautiful Victorian gowns on, stuff like that. And this spread, I was inspired by some 90s and 80s tape cassette images that I found on Pinterest. And I was like, you know what, let me give this a go. And I really like how this turned out. I'm going to turn those into some prints and stickers. This page right here, both were a part of my Inktober series. I drew the one on the left with my left hand, and the abstract one on the right, I drew it with my right hand. I'm practicing to become even-handed when it comes to writing and drawing. So this was me getting some practice in. And if you guys want to see my Inktober series from last year, you can just go on my YouTube channel. You can find my playlist, or you can just scroll through my videos. Okay, for this on the left, I'm definitely turning this into a sticker design, but I want to kind of redesign it a bit, freshen it up, and then maybe do it digitally. And these sketches over here, again, it is like, it's kind of Halloween themed. It was around the Halloween time when I created these. The witches, just, you know, some cute little sketches. And same for here, both of these, even though the one on the left doesn't look like it, she's a witch as well. The one on the left, the one on the right, they're both witches. And I'm thinking maybe I should turn her into a print, but I need to make sure she gives off those witchy vibes. So I'm going to redesign her. And this one, this was a drawing for Inktober as well. I didn't really like how that one came out. It seemed kind of flat to me. This spread, again, the cat person, but this time they're in like regular clothes and they have locks. You know, just kind of messing with of creating this cat character. And you know, you never know, she might end up in one of my comic books as a character. Here, more Inktober work, both on the left and the right. Again, we have another witch character. She's made out of, you know, the micron pens. And each one of these sketches are from like a different day of Inktober, because I was really, really trying to keep up with it, because I really wanted to do every day of Inktober, which I did. And again, you can go watch it on my channel. And here on this spread, we have more flowers. I use Tombow Dual brush pens. I use some fineliners. And the colored paper you guys see throughout, you know, the sketchbook, it's actually origami paper. I just have them all throughout the sketchbook, and I think they're so cool to draw on. This spread right here, this is a Christmas spread. I want to say I did do this after Inktober, you know, because Christmas was around the corner, and I just wanted to do something in spirit of Christmas, even though I don't think Thanksgiving had come up yet, but it's all good. The next spread is not one of my favorites, but I really like it. You know, I do find myself liking abstract pieces from time to time. And to me, this turned out pretty good for, you know, I think I accomplished what I was going for. And for this next spread, we have a bunch of lips. And I was practicing, I was trying to get more practice with my color pencils. And if you were wondering what kind of color pencils I was using, I usually use the Prismacolor Premier color pencil. And again, I was on Pinterest looking at reference images for lips in particular, and just trying to get a good feel on how to draw lips. And it gave me a reason to use my color pencils to, you know, get that practice in and that repetition. And in the middle and in the right, I have vampire teeth, you know, nothing too special. And this is a spread that I created after watching the Nope movie. This spread is trash. I am so sorry. I enjoyed the movie. I enjoyed Kiki Palmer and Daniel Kaluuya. I like Kiki Palmer, and Daniel is one of my favorite actors of all times. And, you know, they did their thing in the movie. So, and shout out to Jordan Peele as well. And for this next spread is another Christmas spread. I used Tombow dual brush pens, some fine liners, and colored pencils, and a white gel pen. Here's another spread, a bunch of treats, cupcakes, some of my favorite things to draw. I think I'm going to turn most of these into some stickers. And if you guys want to visit my website, it's down right now. And I'm going to be gone for a while. So the website actually might be back up December 1st instead of during Halloween like I had planned. But it looks like I'm going to be out of town working for a while. So, but I'll still try to get you guys some content because I had big plans for this channel. So yeah. Here on this spread, we have our little elf girls, you know. And here, this is an Easter spread. It's okay. The color choices. I mean, I tried to do like a Easter, you know, color theme. I mean, I think I kind of halfway got there, but it's okay. This could have been better executed, but it is what it is. And like this hand, like I just really like the concept of drawing a hand with nails. I have stickers similar to that actually on my website. And here on this spread, it's kind of tattoo themed, you know. We have a tattoo artist working on a client. The client has a head made out of flowers. I don't know, I just thought that was cool for whatever reason. Then we have a client who just went crazy with the tattoos, just tattoos from head to toe. And you know how sometimes they have the horns placed on their foreheads, or they have their eyeballs tattooed. That's kind of the theme I was kind of going for with this. And in this spread, we have flowers, more flowers. And at first, the flowers were going to be pink. Well, this flower was going to be pink, and it was going to be done in the wash, in the hemi wash that I had. But I don't know, the gouache isn't necessarily the best gouache to work with. So I'm going to give me some different gouache, and I might re-go over that page or that spread. And for this spread, I have another abstract spread. I really like how this came out. We have another Christmas themed / treat spread. I feel like I should have colored some of these in colored pencil, and I feel like some of them would have come out a little better, you know. But I have to say, my favorite piece is the cake at the bottom. It just looks like you can kind of pick it up off the page and eat it. It looks good. It's my favorite part on this spread. So on to the next spread, we have more lips, except this time is the female version. And again, I'm going to turn some of these into either prints and or sticker designs, maybe even patterns. I'm not sure at this point, but these came out really well. I really enjoyed working with colored pencils, and I plan on using more of these sketches, creating more of these sketches in my future sketchbook. So be on the lookout for that. And with this spread, we have more Japanese food. I think Japanese food is very interesting to draw. I've never actually had, I don't think any of these things, except maybe noodles, but not Japanese style noodles. I always wanted to try Japanese food, but since I don't eat meat anymore, I couldn't eat any of the meat or the sushi. But if they have any veggie options in place of like sushi or whatever, I'm down for it. So on this spread, we have more skulls. And I will have to say the skull on the orange page is one of my favorites. And the skull with the crystals on top of his head, I think that's a really, really cool concept. I think I saw that somewhere and I was like, oh, okay. I kind of want to create something like that. And I might turn it into a sticker design as well. For this spread, we have just flowers and two people on it. It's like they're in a jungle and they're looking at you. You're interrupting their little session. They're trying to figure out what you're doing there. And I thought I was going to turn this into a print, but I might not. So, and for this spread, we have a bunch of candy and sweets, mostly candy, you know. And here my little unicorn man is a sticker design I created. And here is a recreation of it. It's like an updated version I'm trying to do of that sticker. And just, you know, recreate it and sell it as that new design. Here we have our flowers. We have a positive and negative style sketch. I thought about adding color to it, but I was like, you know what? I think this works as is. And here, I actually like this spread, even though it has a couple of problems. Like the smoothness of my Tombow markers, it just was not given. It was not there. And I think some of my markers were actually drying out at this point. But the concept of it, I really like. But the next time, I might use some different markers for this paper in particular. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's me or if it's the paper. But me and the dual brush pens on this paper, it doesn't work. And here we have cupcakes. Cute cupcakes. All the fun little colors. Again, I might turn some of these into sticker designs. I might like redesign some of them and turn them into sticker designs. And we have the donuts in the back as well. And now we're going to turn to the next spread we have here. It was just a fun little spread design, fun little drawings. I also used the Tombow dual brush pens. I used some alcohol based markers for this spread. Yes, so that's why it doesn't look as streaky as some of the other pages. Here I have more skulls. Alright, for this next spread, I actually thought about turning this into a print design. I actually started turning this into a print design. I took it into Clip Studio Pro. I took the sketch into Clip Studio Pro and kind of started to work with it. What I may end up doing is kind of redesigning it a bit and then, you know, selling it on my website. And here is another spread for a person who does not eat meat. I love drawing hamburgers. I don't know, it's just something so satisfying about drawing hamburgers with the fries and all the parts that come with it. Here's another sketchbook spread I actually kind of enjoy, and I might turn this into a print. I will have to redesign it a little and add a couple more elements, rearrange some things, and I'll do it digitally. So, all right, moving on to the next spread. We have more abstract art. It's just pretty much a bunch of doodles, a bunch of different sketches. I use Posca pens. I use my Tombow dual brush pens, some Microns. just a variety of different supplies to create this abstract piece. And here we have a skeleton of a fish. It's easily my favorite thing on this page, and I may even turn this into a sticker design itself. All right, so for our next spread, we have two beings. I guess you can call them aliens. They are from space. Well, they're from a different planet outside of Earth. And I'm actually thinking about developing these two as actual characters for some of my comic books. I'm not sure what their storyline would be, but I have like a general sense of what I want to do with them. And here we have another space piece of a girl and a flower in her face. She too is an alien from a different planet. And I don't necessarily have like a fully developed story for her either, but she may become a regular in one of my comics as well. And I have to say, if you made it this far in the video, I have to say thank you so much for watching this far. I hope you guys enjoyed it thus far. Don't click off the video yet. I still have more to show you. And please leave a like. Comment down below what your favorite page or spread was. Subscribe to my channel for more content. And yeah, just enjoy the rest of the video. Alright, my last spread in the video. We have lips and an eye. This I created using colored pencils, Prismacolor color pencils, and a white gel pen. And here we have more abstract art going on. And here I also used colored pencils, and I want to say a white Posca marker for the highlights. So here you can see the abstract, you know, art behind the lips. And that was my last page. And here is the back of the cover, the front cover, and this was my sketchbook tour. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please, again, like, comment, subscribe, and share. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks.